Okay. Okay. Yeah, I got an error message. Ooh, some scouting circlings not finding anything. Did he see the next base? Yes, he did. So, Battle is not doing too bad. He is almost at the same drone count as Tritz is in the probe count. Ooh, Archon. Archons are very good, but I wonder, this army is so small. And yeah. Oh, Roachworn, that is good. Wait a second, I got the wrong. Wait a second, there we go, sorry. My bad. Yeah, that's when you rush it and you don't have any experience with crisis management. There you go. I'm really sorry, I'm bad at such things. Okay, so we do have the Roaches without any upgrades against 1-1 Protoss. That is no fight you can take. Killing the pylon is nice, but you can't attack into that. You can't attack into that. You will lose heart. You need a fourth base, I would say. You need to get your upgrades rolling. Ooh, so many pylons. I don't like Battle's position at all. We do need... He could need some more... yeah, another queen for creep spread. That would be so good. That would be so helpful. You really could need that. But I don't know. We do see the fourth base finally. And Lurker then. And guess what? No observer! Because Protoss did forget the robotics. Wah, wah, wah. So, if Tritz doesn't realize that there is indeed a Lurker Den going on, and he moves his entire army or over 4 Lurker, for example, this army gets tracked within seconds. But yeah, we will see that. I do have some lag, so I don't know why, and I probably can't fix it, which is really sad. Yeah, I do have a lot of lags currently. Oh no, I'm so sorry. Okay, those armies might clash soon, and I don't see Battle win this. As you can see in the army tab, it's looking great for Drizzt. He's moving in, those rocks already cleared. Ah, he's backing off, those circlings get shrecked! This army, oh, it's so close, it's so small, the Lurkers are morphing! If you can burrow them, but they get picked off, just one Lurker survives, and the Archons are awesome against the Corruptors. The Lurker gets picked off, and I would say that's the end. GG! Drizzt wins this game. Very well done. So, currently 1-1. Okay. Good stuff. So 1-1 currently. And I have to say Battle didn't do too bad, to be honest, against Tritz. It was gold versus platinum. And yeah. I think if Battle would have went for the probes instead of the Nexus, that would have been so much better. He could have had killed like 20 probes. So first going for the Nexus was a good call, I would say. It was good. But after all probes, the Zealots, the Mama Core and the Void Ray went back to defend. If there was the Void Ray already, I don't know. Then you should have turned around the circlings and just attack all the probes and kill as many as possible. Because then he would have been so far ahead, he could have killed, maybe killed Tritz with a Roach Ravager timing. 1-1 out of 3 base, I guess that would have worked quite well. Okay, do we have a next game? Still waiting for our player now, for Team Pro. I don't know where our Pendulo is currently, but he should show up! We need you! Come on! Challenge your fate! No idea what's going on. What I could do is when I wait. I don't know. Okay, got it. Thank you very much. Let me type. Okay, so Tritz will be a spectator? No, he will play, I guess. Okay, so let's see. Pendulo versus Drzt. Another PVC. Come on. So many player, oh my goodness. So I think we can start soon. Tritz is ready. And Pendulo is ready. All are ready. No referee is fine. It's okay. Orbital Shipyard. Okay, I see that. I see that. So we got this awesome, badass music, which you might be able to hear. Very welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to today's clan war between Bad Clown Academy and the Pro Clan, as we have spawning in the top right position of Orbital Shipyard, playing as the Green Protoss, winning his first game. It is Drizzt. And he's playing against the Orange Zerg, playing for the Pro Clan. It is Pendulo SFX, only called Pendulo, going for the double extractor trick. I have no clue if that's worth it or not, but you can do it, and it's okay. And he's going for a good timing on the hatchery, a bit too early with the drone, but that's fine. So hatch first against gate first, into gas. Okay, that's totally fine. And I don't know who's lagging. That's not good at all. Okay, there we have the pool and the gas. And there we see the Nexus. Finally a good luck, have fun from Pendulo. Okay, that's nice. Okay. Oh, the pro waiting for the cybernetics core, I guess. And not gonna scout! Ooh, that's ballsy, I have to say. That's ballsy. That's very ballsy. And there we see finally the good luck fun from Drizzt. Okay. I wonder if this automaton 2000 will have any role in this upcoming war or not. Maybe he needs to clean all the blood and all the Psy. He needs to collect all the Psy blades as well. Okay, we do have the robotics facility. Nexus is on the way, finishing, and income wise it's looking quite even. Okay, we have a third base on the way for Pendulo. That's not bad. Ooh, and the Overlord sees everything. A sentry should not be able to kill that Overlord. Should not be able to kill the Overlord. And the robotics, no threat for the Overlord as well. But the Overlord should spot it. The Overlord could spot it potentially. That would be very helpful. But, ooh. Okay, the sentry might indeed get the Overlord. So, Pendulo, two choices. Go for the scouting, the sacrifice lord, or bring him back into safety. Okay, the Overlord barely makes it out alive. That is good. Oh no, the Overlord dies! Okay, the hatch finishes up. That's good. Some servants are here next to this automaton 2000. And we do see two additional gateways. Still no forge, which is okay, but we do see a robotics facility. Okay. And a lot of circling. So, Pendulo trying what Battle tried, but how will he get into the base? Ooh, Overlord! Look at that Overlord drop! Oh, that's so nice. I get so hyped right now. Ooh, that's... Oh, sneaky. I love it. And this Observer, not spotting it. The Nexus, not spotting it. No pylon, no spotting. Oh, that's so nasty. And there is not much to defend here. I mean, the sentry with two force fields is nice, but the gateways are just now finishing up. There's hardly anything to defend. This could be game-ending, to be honest. Oh, and there we are, the circlings, killing so many worker. 9 in total so far. Pylon overcharge getting activated. He might get the immortal. That could be so good, but... there are the additional circlings coming. He tries to get the sentry? No. Does he try to go down there? So far he didn't deal too much damage, to be honest. He gets not the sentry as well. Oh, that's not too good. But behind that we see 15 more drones were in production, and that's okay. So those two circlings are seeking for any probe they can get. They just get a bit scouting, and they find a weak probe. Oh no! Okay, they get this one probe, and not another one. Okay, so that's that. Okay, then we have the hatchery. A macro hatch, that's helpful. He definitely needs that. Ooh, so many circlings. Again. Let me see if I can follow this guy. Oh yeah, I can. Oh, that's so awesome. So let me check something shortly. Okay, those circlings. And they don't get anything done. Just a bit of scouting and a bit of a nuisance. But that's okay, they might... Okay, that could deal a lot of damage. They could get, indeed, this Nexus. But it's expensive again. I mean, not really, but those circlings are not for free either. Oh, he doesn't get it? Again, this certain mistake. Overreacting and attacking before 1-1. So he's Ling heavy, only circlings. But Zealots are so good against those. But with 1-1, this could be quite good for Pendulo, to be honest. We do see a second macro hedge. Okay, so this is full Ling all in. We do see, is this the lair? Yeah, it is indeed the lair. Oh, that's such an awesome move. I do like that. All those circlings making it into the natural. There's one pylon. Okay, but this could deal so much damage. And more circlings into the main base as well. Those circlings not getting the pylon. But, oh, that wraparound circlings everywhere. Not killing too much here, but they might get the nexus. Okay, the circlings in the main base got cleared. Oh, they almost get the nexus, but not quite. And I don't know why. But I still have heavy legs. Oh, now I know why! I'm so stupid. You know why I have legs? Because the stream went on again. And in the background, I was the whole time watching the stream. I mean, you get it, the stream was on my browser, which is so dumb. So that might be the case why I had problems with the stream here. My problem, sorry, my bad, I apologize. So this time there's a salad, and it's on hold position, and those circlings, they might get it, but is it worth it? I would say no, you need to tank up. We do see 2-2 and the spire, which is good, and a fourth base as well, but Dritz had a very good defense, and income-wise he is ahead, a little bit, gas-wise. And there we see the big gateway explosion. So Dritz might go for attack soon, and I don't think that Pendulo has anything to offer here. I mean, just Zerklings against possibly Archons, a lot of Zealots. That's not good. He needs something strong. Banelings could work. I mean, to be honest, there is not much anti-air. He got 3 Archons and 5 Stalker. With Speed Overlords, he could drop all the Banelings on top of this army, but that needs some practice to be done successfully. And this probe is moving out to potentially get... Where is it moving? A proxy pylon. Maybe. I don't know where this probe is going. It sees all those circlings. I mean, if the circlings get a wraparound on this army, this could be helpful, but Archons are so good against circlings. I mean, they one-shot them, right? Yeah, Archons one-shot circlings here. 39 damage against 35 with one armor, they one-shot circlings. So, all those circlings are almost worthless. If those are banelings, however, they get still one-shotted. One shot, but maybe could work. Oh, that prism is very helpful for reinforcing as well. And army supply wise, it's not looking good. The upgrades are 2-2 against 1-1. That's helping Zerg, but Zerg has only circlings. Mutalis are garbage against Archons as well. And there's the attack coming. I don't think that Pendulo can hold this whatsoever. I really don't think that he can do this. What he would need, because there's no observer with this army. Oh, there is now. Some lurker at that position could be so helpful, but now it's too late. I wonder why Dritz isn't hearing the creep. There you go. And yeah, those mutalists are not doing much. Those banelings are nice. I mean, if the banelings kill all the salads, then maybe. Maybe Pendulo has a chance. Otherwise, I don't see how that should be possible. Itralisks could be very nice against this composition, but Pendulo is so far away from Itralisks. I mean, he got the lair and the infestation pit, but still. Oh, those Mutalisks! Don't lose them! I do love that. That defense, that anchor Archon as well. That's so smart. And there we go. There's the big attack onto this new established fourth base. Hardly mining. and it gets killed and all those drones will go down. Mineral warp, very nice. Most of them are getting away. Maybe not. Charge slots, very good unit. And yeah, the Banelings, only 16. Oh, the Mutalisk, you need a big flank. And he has some legs, that's not good for him. He's pulling back, he's losing the queens. Potentially here. Oh! No, that wasn't the best fungal. Only getting two salads here. He tries to get the connections done, and there you go, but is this looking good? I would say no. So far not. The mutant is going in, there's a big warp in. He should focus fire the warp prism, but he doesn't do it. Now he does it. A bit too late, as everything gets cleared by Dritz, and I think we soon will see the GG from Pendulo. He has nothing to defend, he got the macro edges, but Zerglings are not very good against this army. Maybe if he can kill the Zealots and the Archon, he has a chance, but there are just too many Zealots. The Archon still there, 15 kills, he's a master right now. And the Hatchery goes down. Yeah, I would say that's GG. Well played. GG. And there we go, Dritz winning the next game. Wow. Not bad. Not bad at all. So, currently looking 2-1 for the Bad Clowns Academy. They played quite good. So let's see, what will be the next guy? I mean, Zerglings are nice and you can stick with Zerglings for quite some time, but you need to get something else after that. You simply need to, you can't stick for Zerglings. I mean, in the late game Zerglings are awesome again, but you need to switch it up. As a Zerg player, you need to go for that composition. Then your opponent counters it and you go for a completely different thing. And he needs to adapt again, the opponent. And so it goes the whole time after you finally attack, lose your army, remax and crush him. That is how Zerg basically works. At least that's how I think Zerg basically works. But I could be wrong here as well, so what do I know? So let's see, do we have a next player? Okay, I'm still waiting. I have no idea who's playing next. Okay, what do we have here? I don't think we have a player still selected. But I'm not quite sure. I'm not quite sure here. Oh yeah, and we need a map. Brian Terraces. That was already played. Okay, so no Prime Terraces for this guy. Another CVP, Dusk Towers. Ah, that's okay. Dusk Towers is okay. He didn't have any Dusk Towers so far. Alright, dust towers. Good, good, good. After that game, I think I need to go to the toilet shortly. Because I did not expect that I have to cast this clan war today. So, yeah. But you have dust towers. And I'm also quite thirsty. Don't have anything to drink here. And I don't want to die like those World of Warcraft nerds that are playing 3 days in a row without eating, going to the toilet or drinking. I mean, what the frick. But, okay. okay. So let's see. Okay. So I'm not playing against Ed Sador. That's so true. So we have finally reached some high skill level here. Master versus Diamond. That's okay. Acid. Acid, acid. Who is this guy? Victor is bad. Amnesia Haze. Okay, Amnesia is playing a Zerg. Looking good, I would say. So, is Tritzt ready? Okay. Okay, we are already starting. Sorry. You need to look at my stream. Welp. Stuff happens. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, very welcome again to this clan war, now on Dusk Towers, as we are spawning in the left bottom position, playing as a green Zerg for the pro team. It is Amnesia Haze or Victor is bad. And he's playing against the pink Protoss, spawning in the right top position of Dusk Towers, playing for the bad clown Acadamy. It is Dritzt. And this guy already gave the pro clan, my clan, quite some trouble. So let's see if Amnesia Haze or Victor is bad. I call you now Victor is bad because that's the name you have displayed here. Victor is bad. Whoever Victor is, I have no clue. But let's see if Victor is bad can do this against Dritzt. I can be so lucky that those guys are not choosing to go for names like Protoss or Terran or Zerg. There was once a guy, I don't know him. Oh, triple hedge, what? Greed! Okay, so that can backfire quite heavily, but also can be very strong. There was once a guy who played, like, I mean, maybe it were two guys as well. And one was called Protoss, and then he played Zerg. And the other guy was Terran, and he was called Zerg. And then, it was so difficult. I mean, I didn't cast it, I just heard it. And I don't know. It has to be so weird. If you want to say Protoss, but the Protoss player is called Zerg, and stuff like that. It must be so confusing. Okay, whatsoever. Okay, pool and gas. 4 victory is bad. And we have the standard opening for Dritz here, who was very successful with defending his Nek'Sai the entire game. And we do see this time a Robotic, so no Stargate. He switches it up quite a bit, and that's good. Robotics facility is very viable and strong as well. You can go for Immortal, which are very strong. You can go for an Observer to scout out your opponent's base. You can go for Disruptor later on when you get the Robotics Bay, or for Colossus. Both are viable options in my opinion. I would say a mixture of Disruptors and Colossus is the best addition to your army, because you have the burst damage from the Disruptors and the constant damage from the Colossus. Yep, the Colossus got nerfed in addition compared to Heart of the Swarm, but it's still a very viable and good unit, in my opinion. And we do see a Forge, so possibly cannons and plus one. We will see. What I really wonder is, he's going, okay, Observer is there, because so far Dritz did not... What is this? Yeah, okay. Dritz did not scout whatsoever. Oh, this Overlord possibly gets picked off. A second sentry, okay. So this disruption beam tickling this Overlord to its death. And there's the Ops. Okay, plus one, and the Immortal is on the way. And it looks like this probe wants to go out. Oh, nice. Oh, mineral walking. Oh, you can mineral walk even when you have minerals in your hand. That's a good thing to know. Didn't know that. Okay, those weapons pick off the probe, which is nice. Oh, the Overlord barely escapes. And all those Zerglings might die here to this Mothership core. Oh yeah, they won't get the Salad. They do see, however, the Nex is going up. And there we have Hydrolist Stand and Double Evolution Chamber. So income-wise, it's still quite equal. Despite Victor is bad going for a Triple Hatchery. Very interesting stuff here. So a second Immortal is out, we have a third one on the way. A slight supply block for Dritz, but that's okay. Oh, Pylon Wall. To be honest, a Pylon Wall, it's not as strong. Yeah, you can't say as strong, because the duration of the Photon Overcharge got buffed, as well as the attack speed of the pylons, but it costs more energy, so you can't overcharge them 8 times, only 4 times now, so it's not that effective anymore, I would say, in defending long sieges, but for short battles it's still very powerful, even more powerful than before, I would say. The Phoenix did see the Hydrolist then. This Protoss army is still quite small, but you do have the pylons and the Photon Cannon, which is nice. And here's the Templar Archive, so we will see most likely Archons again, which is very good against Hydralisks and Zerglings. Oh, the Hydralisks have both upgrades ready already, that's quite something. And then we see the Hydralisks then morphing into a Lurker then. So, Victor is bad, going for the Lurker. As he knows, Lurker are very powerful. Okay, so Templar Archive is finished. We do see plus 2 attack for the Protoss Ground Army, very strong. It's still quite a small army, but I do think, there are the 5 gateways already in the production tab. As you can see, and one probe is moving out. Just a little bit. Not going too far. That's okay. Oh, but as you can see, Victor's band is moving out to attack. Possibly. Or maybe just to contain and siege up the third base of Dritz. But yeah. I don't think he can break him. To be honest, shoot with all those are a lot of hydroliths, but they don't have much health, so they die fast and hard. And I don't think that Victor is bad at attacking there. He's just containing him. Maybe morphing some lurker. Oh, losing those serpents was unnecessary. But forcing on the Fortanova charge, and he is going into it, but just baiting out a lot of more photon overcharges. So this mothership core has just energy for one more overcharge, and as you can see, it deals a lot of damage very fast with a quite good range, but doesn't last too long, to be honest. Okay, another cannon going up, some archons. He doesn't have storm. Storm would be so useful, because storm can kill, almost kill a Hydrolisk. Hydrolisk has the regeneration from the Zerg, so it will survive with 1 or 2 HP, but it's still quite a lot if it stays there. So, that Lurker? Huh. As long as Victor is bad, is sieging up here and containing Dritzt, and having his 4th base up and running, and going for Hive, he's fine. But he needs to be careful, because there's the War Prism on the way. Ooh, look at that, they have range 9. This one not attacking, but he's going in like that, and the Zealots, you can see, they are melting heavily. 2 Lurkers are getting picked off, almost, just one so far. And that looks like a difficult fight to take. He needs to stay in the range of the Lurker. It's like with Terran, you need to fight with your tanks. But those Lurkers provide a lot of firepower, and that's why Colossus would be nice, or yeah, maybe Disruptor would be the better choice here. And he goes in, clumped like crazy, Lurker dealing so much damage, nice kiting back, he can clear it Dritzed here, and now just Hydralisks are left. He tries to kite, but he's on the retreat. And he has some legs. Okay, I don't have any legs now, so that's good. Good for me as well. What does PB mean? I don't know. Okay, it looks like we are going back into this game. There we go. Okay, he's morphing some Lurker. That's not the best position to morph a Lurker. That one neither. Oh, those eggs take so much damage. Ah, he's pulling back, okay. I mean, those Archons are quite injured, shield-wise. And yeah, Hydrolisks with 2-2 are quite good. Look at that, they're dealing quite a lot of damage. Getting a good flank, very important here. The Warpin is real, Hydrolisks don't have any buffer. The flank with the Zealots, not dealing too much damage here, and Dritz needs to retreat. Focus firing, the Warp Prism, and he gets it, very nicely done. And I think Victor's bat is pushing again, so it's a bit of a back and forth. Oh, those gateways with those two pylons, if he could snipe those somehow, that would be so massive. Taking a 4th base, that's good. That gateway got completely forgotten about, as well as that one. 4 observer, ooh, someone used the all army hotkey there, that's not good. Don't use that hotkey if you can avoid it. Blink is on the way, but you don't have any stalker. Yep. Okay, for now. I mean, maybe later he needs it. We do see the Hive is on the way, and +3 ground attack finishes right now. But those Lurkers are so strong, dealing so much damage, especially against armored units like the Immortal. So this 4th base, no way near to go down, to go up, to get completed. Oh, this cannon has no energy, will get killed. And Victor's bat goes in, he's maxed now. Those Archons are very powerful, but nice kiting back into those Lurker shots. And I would say slowly but surely, he's picking Dritzt apart. Yeah, that's looking very good here. Almost no army left here for Dritzt, and Victor's bat is pushing through it with all those Hydrolisks. That is how you do it. Maybe. There we go, GG 2-2 in this best of 7 clan war. What a game. So I need a toilet break and need to get something to drink. So be right back in 2 minutes. Okay, I'm back. Time to continue the action. Where are we? Let me have a look here. So do we have another player? Wow. Okay. So for Backlone Academy, Green will play. I don't know about this player, but probably is pretty damn good because he's playing in game 5, which is quite at the end of any clan war. So probably he's a Master League player. Master Protoss. Oh no. So okay. So that was a good break. Yep. A very good break. Okay, I'm really ready. Okay. Oh, yep. Oh, Irina! Ooh, Irina, that's such a... I don't know how Sir can play on a map like Irina, or how any player, despite... No, not despite, except Protoss, can play on that map. I mean, that map is pure cancer in my opinion. Ah, That's so bad. Okay, so we do have Irina. Okay, there we go. Nice. Oh, green is currently diamond, but probably he's ex-Master League. Oh, yeah. Letters, career summary. Last season he was Master League. Okay. Alright, I see that. So all seem to be ready. We are locked and loaded. Referee no BO, CVP 2. It's currently 2-2. As the score is. So yeah, oh Irina, that has to be an action-packed game, I think. Most likely. Probably not, but most likely. So, ladies and gentlemen, here we are on Irina in this best of 7 clan war between the Pro Clan and the Bad Clown Academy. As you have spotted in the left top position, as the Blue Cirque playing for the Pro Team, it is Victor is Bad. And he's fighting against the Purple Protoss, spawning in the left bottom position of Arena, playing for the Bad Clowns Academy. It is Green! Hoping you all enjoy the stream. If you have any feedback, suggestions, just let me know in the chat. Oh yeah, heck yes! Gonna be a good one. And the good thing is, because there are no turns, I'm learning a lot about PVC, CVC today in this clan war, so I really enjoy that. This probe moving out so far. I wonder why. Oh, scouting and the nexus before the gate raid. That's very interesting, especially on a map like that, but maybe that's the way to go. So here's the probe. We'll confirm hatch first. Okay, saw it all. It's okay. Yeah, roger, roger. You lost. Burr, burr, burr. And there's a drone, and he saw it. And he might check later on if there's a third base going down, because he sees no pool? No gas? Excuse me. What? That's crazy. Please call me, maybe. And there we see the pool. And potentially a gas. Potentially. Gas? No. For green we have gate and double gas. And yeah, green of course checks the hatchery. Ooh, this drone. Maybe checking for some pylons. Proxy pylons with cannons can be so nasty to deal with. There we go. Extractor. Oh, look at that, this drone. Waiting for the hatch to finish. Burp. Oh, it's not mining, there we go. Okay, and we do have cybernetics core and a second gateway, so this could be potentially for some aggression. And because of the small rush distance, maybe war prison play comes into this game. Finally, this overlord needs to move soon, because cybernetics core will move, will finish at some point. And then Stalker might happen and kill this overlord. The drone count not looking too good here. 4 Victor is bad compared to green, but it's fine because Protoss has the double chrono boost, and so far he was using it on the Maxi. Now he's going for double adapts, and we only have queens so far as defense for Victor is bad, which he is using. One for creep spread, the second one for inject, the third one is on the way, and he's getting speed upgrade, but he needs something else to deal with the adepts, because circlings are not really good. And I could think that those two adepts are going to attack shortly. Yeah, just harass, scout a little bit, look what you can deal damage to, and that's it. So does the shade go away and then I follow the adept? Yes, it does. So there we go. Roach run on the way, and we do see a spore crawler. Nice focus fire on the circlings, killing 3 of them, potentially 4 of them, without taking any damage, just shield damage. Very well done from green here. Not the biggest issue here for Victor is bad, but still, it's a bit annoying. Ooh, probe going for a pylon maybe? Yeah, there we go, pylon, and that's really strong. Pylon adept, need to pull back, losing one adept here, killing all those circlings, the mothership comes into play. Finally, and Victor is bad as pulling the drones here to kill this pylon. And he needs to do this because the photon overcharge is so strong. There's the cancel, and green did some good damage here. Oh, this queen! Heavy danger! Pull it back onto creep, and it gets this boost! But yeah, overall, it's quite equal, I would say. Victor is bad, lost some mining time, can pick off a probe, which is nice. And behind that we see a gateway. Stargate was there, going for a phoenix, slightly supply blocked here, green is, and oh, with the photon overcharge, oh, the adept lives with 4 HP. One circling claw attack would have been all it needed to kill it off, but hey, that's okay. This green should inject and get some creep spread going. Come on, Victor, you can do it. Victor's bad. You do see double gas taking at the natural. Hive, not anywhere near, but the lair's on the way, and a third base, third extractor tech, sorry, the fourth one in total. Ooh, robotics. So now we have every tech pass for Protoss. We have the Twilight Council, the robotics facility, and of course the Stargate. And this phoenix is indeed real, so on the hunt for any overlords, might fight that one, find that one or that one. Circlings killing those rocks off. Oh, that overlord. Ah, what's going on with my mouse? Holy. Oh, 2 phoenixes out already. So we have Phoenix Charge Lord, which is very strong. But as we can see, we have the Hydralisk then, and Hydralisk Lurker should be able to deal with that composition quite good. But if green adds some disruptor, then this could be completely different again. And this overlord is so bad. I have to say, Phoenix is one of the few units Protoss has which I really like design-wise. It's not overpowered, it's not broken, it's not stupid as, it's just a nice Protoss-fitting unit. Ah, picking up a drone! Very nicely done. Oh, might find here another kill. I did pick off a larva. Now going for the drone, but might lose an... So close. Almost lost the Phoenix there. Still, not the biggest issue here for Victor's band. But drone-wise, he's not max. He needs some drones more. Oh, another overlord getting killed here. So that's the third one, I think. Oh yeah, that's summing up. And now Victor is bad is indeed supply cap. The creep spread also not the best one. This queen definitely needs to inject. Come on, Victor, you can do it. Even though you don't have enough money yet to use all the larva you get, later you will need those injects. The army supply currently is 13 lurkers and 12 circlings against 6 adepts, 5 stock. That's not looking good. He can lift all the hydrolisks with the Phoenix and then just roll over this Zerg army, which is probably what he's going to do. But here we see lurker morphing. That's very good. Ooh, what is that? Pylons, pylons, more pylons, pylons. We do have a Templar Archive, now finished up for green. Ah! Carefully! Oh, that's a good position! There is no observer with this army currently. Don't lose all the circlings, be careful, pull back, maybe he's going straight for the Nexus. And do we see a weird counter-attack? Base trade scenario? We could. The Nexus might fall here, but at what cost? A lot of stuff died, and he's picking up the lurker here with the Phoenix. Who will win? He needs to burn those lurker. Come on, burn them. Not the best focus fire, but I guess Victor is bad is clearing this army somehow. Potentially, at least he's good trading here. He gets the immortal and the stalker and the Phoenixes. I would say Victor is bad broke green here. Pew! Because there's not much left to defend. Just some zealots. I mean, I think against Zerg and Terran, you need some kind of splash damage. You simply need that. I mean, at that position, imagine 4 disruptor shots. There, 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 and there hitting. Killing everything. But now green needs to remake his Nexus. And he can't really afford it because the main base almost mined out, so he would need the fourth base as well already. So that's not looking too good here as well. Oh, look at the damage! Ooh, killing 2 zealots, which is in this position green is currently in. It is huge. Zerg is approaching to attack the natural, killing so many probes in this process. Not enough energy on this mothership core to photon overcharge all those pylons. The zealots are melting like crazy. And the Archon and Immortal, they stay no chance. Oh, the Archon! It lives, but for how long? The second Nexus falls here. 11 HP! Kill it off! No! He's trading with the army. The positioning is quite good between the natural and the third base. And he's killing those buildings. He should... there you go. Nexus falls. And I don't see green winning. He's pulling all the probes, but there we go. GG well played! Very well done. So, pro team only one game away from winning this clan war. Okay. Very nice. Very nice so far. So, potentially, we have only one more game to see, cast, play, and enjoy, and then that's it. But maybe Maybe Victorious Bad loses the next game, and then we will have an ace match. Could see an ace match. So the barcode is playing. Whoever that is, let's view his profile. Ex-Protoss again. So it looks like the Bad Clown Academy don't have any talents, neither the Pro Clan, at least in this clan war. So let's check his statistics. All seasons? Okay, not too bad here. Not bad. He's not too good against Terran. He's quite good against Zerg and Protoss, and was Diamond in just this season. Was he in Heart of the Swarm? He was Master League. Okay, so he's newly come to Legacy of the Void. Well, okay, we will see how that plays out. Okay. Good, good, good. Yep, all I can say is I have to wait now for the map. So we have Protocol or Ruins of Seras. I do think we will see Ruins of Seras. Although it would be nice. Yeah, there is Seras. Although it would have been nice to see Central Protocol being picked. But that's okay. I mean, who likes Central Protocol, to be honest? I do like the design of the map. I mean, not how it's shaped, but the look, the doodads and stuff they used for the look of the map. But the design itself, like where the bases are, the ramps and the backdoor rocks, I really dislike it. It's so damn difficult to take a third base on that map, because the third base and the natural are most of the time so far away from each other. But yeah, we'll see. So, Central Protocol. Okay, so maybe I don't have to play whatsoever today. Interestingly, we didn't see too many early game shenanigans, all in two base pushes to try to end the game so far in this clan war. Every game, if I remember right, at some point was most likely just macro, which is somehow cool. But I would like to see some action-packed games, some base trade. Some battle cruiser operational, but we are not going to get this. Most likely. Not in another PVC. Not in a PVC. Okay. So, barcode is ready. It's amnesia already. Okay. So let me check the stats first. We have 3 games won by Pro Clan and 2 games won by Bad Clown Academy. So let me set the score. Okay, and here we are, ladies and gentlemen, in this best of 7 clan war between the Pro Clan and the Bad Clowns Academy. We are spawning in the right bottom position of Ruins of Seras, As the blue serf playing for Team Pro it is, Victor is bad! And he's playing against the teal Protoss player spawning in the left top position of Ruins of Serfs, playing for his clan, Bad Clowns Acadamy. Can he bring the series back? It is Barcode! Okay, so it is cross position. So this could be potentially a very long game. And I have to say, even though I really don't like this map, some games I watch, like in GSL or IEM or DreamHack or whatsoever, or WCS Qualifier, on that map were awesome. They were so action-packed, back and forth, so exciting. So maybe we will see a high-level, super awesome game here as well. But we will see. For now we have Nexus, Gateway, and two simulators for our barcode Protoss. And we do have Hatch into Pool for Victor is bad, which is also nice and safe. The probe scouts around and the drone scouts around and will confirm. Ah, there he is. Look at that sneaky little boy getting a Nexus. Ooh, this drone could block the cybernetics core. Well, maybe not. Ah, tries to. Oh, wow. That probe sneaking around like a ninja. We have a third base going up already. So Victor's bad going for the macro again. Could be Hydrolisk Lurker. But I don't know. So we have a second gateway going up for our barcode Protoss. Gas being mined for Victor's bad, producing some drones and queens. Just one queen currently, interestingly. So we'll go with the creep spread at this with this queen from the beginning or not? Stargate opening for barcode Protoss. Okay, spitting into this hatch tree, getting the larva. Bleh. Disgusting suck. Ooh, this barcode! You're patrolling at the wrong side of the map! I mean, not the map, but the wrong expansion. It's over here! Well, he will find out at some point. Nice patrol command. Stargate almost finishing up. And yeah, a lot of gas being mined for a barcode so far. Ah, the queen might kill the probe. Oopsie. There we go. Ah, the probe not making it into the main base. He doesn't want to lose it, but... Ah, the circlings might kill it. So the probe... Oh, that block! Ah, he sees the creep. Now he knows that there is the base. We should see the creep. Yeah, definitely. So, Phoenix base play so far. Two adepts, one salad, which is more than enough to hold any circling aggression at the beginning of the game. Ah, Phoenix find that Overlord. Another pylon. There's one Overlord as well. Circling at the watchtower. Very good decision. Get all the vision you can get at this map. So what is the tech choice for Victor is bad? So far, double evolution chamber. Nothing special. He gets one spore here. He got spores at the main, but not at the natural. He's going for the Hydrolisk then again. So the Phoenix are joining together, hunting for overlords, not finding anyone at their current path. Robotics facility, another Phoenix. There you see the Phoenix. Can you see it? The shape of the Phoenix. That's how you do it. Okay, some circlings moving around, seeing another Phoenix. We'll see the mothership core, we'll see no third base currently, so that's fine. And income wise, Victor's bad is a little bit ahead. There we see the gateway explosion from barcode, a warp prism, and 1-1, as well as the muscular augments for the hydrolisks. More and more Phoenixes are being produced. There is no forge for the barcode protoss currently, so no upgrades. And later on, this could that could take a bad route here for the Bad Clown Academy protoss. But we will see. The Phoenixes are hunting all those overlords. Might get some, but guess what? The Hydroliths are there, and they are quite good at shooting things. Okay, Phoenixes killing one Hydrolisk there, getting out alive, taking some damage here, but that's fine. For a Hydrolisk, not too bad. Oh, that's a big push coming. What's the army currently? 10 Hydrolisks, 18 Zerglings, and 10 drones! That's the total wrong time to go for drones, buddy. Can you hold it? He sees it. Does he see it? He sees it. Panic! Panic! You need to produce stuff! He's supply capped. Oh no, that's not really good. 1-1 will finish, however. But he needs to start spying, spore, something. 6 more Hydroliths are coming, but is this enough? Can he hold? Good force fields blocking off some Zerglings. It's a very tough decision here for Victor's Bad. Will he be able to hold this? If he does, this two-base push could be the end of this clan war. Otherwise, nice focus fire on the Phoenix, but good time bomb, very good force fields. There are some Hydroliths coming from the back, pulling all those drones to defend, but Adepts are very good at shooting and killing drones and Hydroliths, as both are light units, and the third base definitely will go down here. So, 8 more Zerglings, 7 more Hydroliths. The Lurker then... Oh... Did the War Prism just die? No, it was the Observer. Okay, the Observer died, so if he can morph some Lurker, then maybe there's a chance he holds, but damage taken already, and he morphs one Lurker, that's not enough! Needs more and more time! 10 seconds to go! That's not gonna happen, he's pulling the probes! Nice focus fire on the Lurker egg! And I think that's the GG zone, look at that! Oh, one Lurker finishes up! Burn it fast! No, it dies! That was his last hope, and there we go! 3-3! Okay, so it's getting very exciting over here. Very exciting. So we have 3-3 currently. Okay, so we have the last map, which will be Central Protocol. And that map, I have to say... Oh man, yeah, that's the game. Sometimes you lose, and sometimes the other guy wins. That's life, man, that's life. Yep. So I do think Central Protocol will be the last map for today. For today's clan war. So if I can freely choose for the last map, yeah, so why should I, yeah, see? Okay, no problem. So, come on, let's do this. Okay, so I won't turn off the stream. It's totally fine. I will just play and hardly talk whatsoever. If they only would open the lobby. But yeah, we will see. Backdoors. I really don't like the backdoor rocks, but that's the map. So there we are. Let's see. Oops. Protoss. The only hope I have is that he doesn't have a good win-loss against Terran in the last season. But whatsoever, I'm ready. Okay. Okay, can we start already? Okay, it looks like we can go. Final map and match of the day. Woo! So now it's totally fine. I will play it like that. I don't switch off now the stream channel overlay whatsoever. I just play now. Central Protocol. I have no clue how to play this matchup on that map. Probably I'm sucking very hard, but whatsoever. Bleh. SCV ready. I'm already playing so bad. Already playing so bad, so I don't know what I should do here. I don't know. I really don't know. So let's try it like that. Scout around like that. Should be fine. That's looking good. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. Nice. Okay. Put some guys into the gas. That's okay as well. Stupid probe. So maybe it could be cross spawn or he's down there. One of both have to be the case here. Okay. I don't know where the probe is. What's going on? Okay, he's not top left. Will do. Okay. Upgrade complete. So that's good. That's okay. Oh god, that supply depot is the only entrance. Complete. That's not good. So, I don't know why, but the mining on that map sucks ass, to be honest. It's so bad. I mean, everything I produce is so super late. So he's not down there. So I do know where he is. I just look there at this natural and that's it currently. Do I need another gas? No, not for the build I'm going. So there's the Nexus. So if any Oracle is on the way now, I should be fine. You can go back there to mining. Okay. I do need, however, another supply depot. And that one. And maybe another supply depot here. So that's that. Let's try to get another base up. I don't know if that's safe or not, to be honest. But I can at least try. So go for double barracks behind that. Oh, that's perfect! Oh yeah, there you go! That's so good. And there's a Widow Mine. Getting a pylon. There we go. Dropping over there. Getting a tank. Because why not? Uh-oh, there's a prison. Need to kill the prison. Ah, Dark Templar, okay. That's bad for me. So, get a supply. Oh, come on. That's not good. That's good. Can I get a turret here, please? Yes. So I'm really playing shit today, currently. That's good. I think I got this. So this Widow Mine got cleared. Yes, the Widow Mine still. So. And combat shields, more stuff here. I do think that's the better choice here. So I'm not scanning now any further. I save the rest of my energy for another scan when I attack.
Forces.
There he goes, clearing the Widow Mine. Oh no! Oh, I'm playing so bad here, holy. Get in the mothership, that's big! Yeah, I don't fall for that, Colossus. Widow Mine, good one. DTs. The Colossus not real. Get an Overseer maybe. Observer, I mean. And back for now. So I definitely need to take another base here. Oh, come on! Flights here. Ready for pickup? Research complete. Where's the emergency? Want a piece of me, boy? Okay. Combat shields would be nice. I totally forgot about those. So I do need some defense here. So let's see if I can make this happen. How many scans do I have left? Two soon. That's good. Maybe Liberator would be the way to go. I do need to make sure that there are no hidden bases. And definitely need to make sure I'm not having a supply cap like I currently are. Okay, I can't attack like that. Are there any storms? No. So with the Liberator, I should be able to close this one out. So maybe I drop right into that. Force some reaction. Here's the Liberator. Sim, good unit. I guess I got it. GG. Oh god, I was so bad. But at least I did it. Whew. That map. DTs, man. DTs. But the drop did so much damage. I wanna see the drop again, because I never thought it would deal that much damage here. So let me shortly have a look how much damage I dealt. So it was Gateway Scout, okay. You could have blocked the reactor right there with the probe. That would have been so nasty. Okay, Cybernetics, there's the Nexus, Twilight Council. Did I see the Twilight? No, I did just check for the... Ah, okay. But I guess I was super dumb because look at that. The Dark Templar Shrine was back here. Okay, but... No, it's super. Yeah, Dark Templar can be at 4 minute 15. They can be warped in. So, there is one Dark Templar on the map right here. But guess what? Now the drop comes into game. Boost, he sees it. Doesn't see the Widowmine. Oh, that spot. And now the Widowmine comes down here. He does pull because he only did react. Look at that. Okay, it's that probe right there. But he clumps up. Bam! 9 kills. And I got some more with the Marines. And now he's down to 30 against 35. Against a Terran which has mules. Yeah. And this Widowmine killed an adept. So I get a pylon as well. And there's the warp prism. With only 2 Dark Templar. Luckily for me, I got enough energy left for 2 scans. And I did see with the shades of the Dark Templar where they are. So I was able to take out that one and that one. And because of the drop, he went back with the warp prism. And he didn't deal any damage to me. I mean, that Dark Templar kills him, but here is the Widowmine again. And it kills 4 more probes. And you splash damage to the High Templar. And then you can see that it's a supply that was game after that. Okay, so just in case you wanna see more of me, I am on YouTube. And I definitely will self-promote myself right now. So please, if you like, only if you like. If you don't like, it's fine. But if you wanna see more Terran gameplay, I'm playing currently Legacy of the Void campaign playthrough. You can follow me on YouTube, you can subscribe if you want to. You can follow me on Twitch as well, or on Twitter, AlexSasha92, you will find me. And with that said, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoy. It was an awesome clan war. Very good games out of both the bad clown academy and the pro games, pro teams. So yeah, I wish you a very good evening and bye bye.